I want to feel you. I need to hear you. You are the light that's leading me to the place where I find peace again.
So even before you were born, in Jeremiah 29:11, God says, "For I alone know the plans that I have for you, plans for good and not evil, for a future and a hope." See, God's got those plans for you, and He's got the future and He's got the hope. But too often we put that in our families and our job, money in the bank, and if we have a nice house, the bills are paid, what we look like, what others perceive us as. See, in the end, that's meaningless. And I'm not here to insult you or tell you that your life is meaningless, because it's not. Because I know that God loves you as much as He loves me, and He loves your neighbor as much as you, and that guy at work that you can't stand as much as you. His love is so abounding. It's for everyone. And that's kind of weird to think about too sometimes, because there's people that you just can't stand, but trust me, He loves them. His word says so. And so what I'm here today to say is that God's purpose, it's been fulfilled. See, the plan for your life, it's been fulfilled. But it's a two-way street, because God wants a relationship with you. And a relationship isn't a one-way thing. It's not just God reaching out to you, because God is there every single moment of the day, constantly reaching out to you. We're the ones that are stubborn and have too much pride and don't reach back to Him and don't seek Him. Which is kind of crazy, because if we had any clue, any real idea how good God was, how much His Son Jesus loves us, we would just fall down on our feet and cry and worship Him. In fact, that's what we'll do when we go to heaven, when we get to go to heaven, because of our relationship with Him. And spend eternal life with the Father and the Son. See, those plans that He talked about in Jeremiah 29:11, really, that's been fulfilled, because in John 3:16 He says, "For God so loved the world, everybody, that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish but have everlasting life." See, all we have to do is believe that Jesus was sent here by God, and He took all of our sin, all the things that separate us from God, because He's so holy, He took that upon Himself as a sacrifice so that we could have that relationship. That is so awesome. 'Cause you